And just like snowflakes, no two mums are exactly the same, and Shirley is here to show us how to grow a beautiful and long-lasting fall favorite. I'm talking about the chrysanthemum.
I know.
Of course.
As you know, you said it right when you said that they're no two alike. Actually, a lot of people think mums are mums, like they've seen them, but a lot of people have never really paid attention to mums, and they're so beautiful, and they're everywhere right now in the fall, at the market, you can find them everywhere.
Okay, and you've got an illustration of how many different types of flower the mums are.
Yep.
What type of flower is the chrysanthemum? Like what, where does it fall in?
Well, it's an interesting flower because it's annual and there are varieties that are perennials.
Okay.
But here's the deal. It's a tropical plant, so it does bloom in the fall.
That's so surprising.
And yeah, and there are many different kinds. I want to show you something here.
Okay.
Have you ever seen a spider mum?
I have earlier today
with you.
Okay. Hey, no, these
isn't this cool?
These are beautiful.
Like some people would not know that this is a chrysanthemum and called spider because it's got all these little legs.
Sure, sure.
Very beautiful. And professionals, they classify chrysanthemums in 13 different types, but there's hundreds of varieties.
Okay.
Here's another one here. These beautiful purple ones and the ones in the vase up here are called palms or little, like they're like little buttons. And so these are the button type. And you can just enjoy little
They're
miniature
so
look.
They're so gorgeous.
And look at the front.
Okay.
Here we have yellow ones that look like dahlias, and those are called pom-poms.
Yeah.
And right next to it, there's a different style.
These are all of the same type of flower. They're all chrysanthemums.
They're all chrysanthemums,
different types
look
of
how
them.
Different they are.
Yeah.
Look at this one. Looks like a daisy.
You say they're tropical flowers, and yet they grow in the fall. That's so surprising.
I know,
to me.
It's
ironic. And they like the cold weather, so they grow and thrive when the weather gets a little cooler.
Yeah, I mean, tropical, you think it's got to be sweltering hot.
Yeah.
But no, you know, plants have an internal clock.
Okay.
And they want something, and it's going to cause them to grow, and that's this. They need a shorter day.
Okay.
And you know, the fall, we have shorter days.
Yeah.
And they need cool temperatures. And that's
Perfect.
When they know it's time to open up and flower.
Perfect. How cold can they handle, though?
Well, here's the thing. There are different types of mums. Usually you'll find florist mums, the kind that you find at the store right now, friends. Those are not going to last through the freeze. Those you can decorate with, decorate your porch, bring them indoors.
Sure.
They're beautiful for everyone around the country. But if you live in a cold climate area, you have to know about mammoth mums. And they were created and developed at the University of Minnesota. Take a look at these pictures.
Yeah, they know something about cold.
Okay, now, this is how much they know about cold.
Okay.
They can survive minus 50 degrees.
Minus
that doesn't sound like a tropical
50.
Plant, but they can. So look for mammoth mums. And now the secret, though, guys, to having beautiful mums in your landscape right now, sometimes you drive, you see your friends with the beautiful mums actually planted.
Yep.
Those need to be planted in the spring because it gives it enough time to establish roots so that it could last through the summer. And, you know, give you the glorious show.
I feel like I'm falling in love with mums all over again.
I love it.
So now you're gonna teach me how to plant a container of mixed mums.
Yes.
Right? So how do we start?
Well,
and mixed mums because?
Because I just think it's something decorative. You can really have fun with your mums.
Okay.
And don't just, you know, buy one and set it out. I'm gonna show you how to create something really beautiful. But here's my inspiration, guys. You see this beautiful, gorgeous, large mum display here. When you look at it, you wonder, well, how did they get it to be that large? Well, there are varieties that will grow large like this, but typically, if you look closely, there's about five small plants about this size that are planted in here in a special way, and that's
so
what I want to show you how to do.
So that's the secret. So you plant five or so in the same container.
That's right.
Let's get started.
All right, should we do the same color, or do you want to mix it up?
I want to mix it up.
Good. I was going to say I'm going to mix it up anyway.
Okay, that was the right answer.
I love it.
Okay,
you're going to get dirty.
Okay,
I want you to loosen up these.
You got it.
Just loosen up.
And you just, this helps the roots get established in here. Yeah.
Yes.
Sure.
And friends, what you want to do, get a wide rim container like this one.
Okay.
It's kind of wide, and I've got very well draining soil because the enemy of a mum is to be bathed in. Oh, I'll take a little bit more. It's okay to do that.
Okay. Very good.
To be bathed in soil in water. It does not want that.
Okay.
So I'm going to put this one in the middle. But take a look at what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to and help me here.
Sure.
Evenly space the other mums around it.
Okay.
And I want you to notice something. When I take this out of this container, I'm going to actually lay it this way, sideways, because we want to fill this area.
So you want that domed effect
like
we have here in the front
just
with
like
those
the
beautiful
front.
Purple guys.
So
okay, good.
So you can hold me.
Okay,
come on.
I'm going
you said
in.
You want to get, but you don't have a glove.
I don't need gloves.
That doesn't stop you?
No.
Okay,
come on.
Good. All right, let's do it.
Get my hands dirty. So you just get them in there.
Yeah, get it in there.
I like that little angle, that little...
Yep.
planting them on that angle like that so you get the domed effect. How much, and you talked about them being planted in well-draining soil.
Yeah.
How often should you water them?
You know what? These are thirsty plants.
Okay.
These plants, friends, need to be checked every day. They actually have very shallow roots, and so they tend to dry out very, very quickly. But again, the well-draining soil is because you don't want the soil to pond with water. You want the water to flow through, kind of hang out with a little
bit. So they need a little drink of water as it sort of passes by and drains. Well, they don't want to be like sitting in a pool.
No, they don't.
Okay, now I've also heard people talk about pinching the mums. Tell me why that's important.
Okay. Pinching mums. Here's the thing. Remember I said if you live in the northern climates, actually anywhere in the country, if you want landscaped mums in your yard, plant them in the spring. But what's going to happen 2 months later, like say early summer, you're going to start seeing these guys. See these beautiful little buds?
Yeah.
You don't want your flowers to open up during the summer. So you pinch them. And here's what you do. All you do is you grab the bud and you just pinch it off.
And like you do that in the summer so that you're saving it. For the fall bloom. Okay,
that's
great.
Right.
So you just kind of get
in
there.
All right, stop doing it.
We want it's fall. It's fall. Come on now. I'm getting excited. This is so great.
But now you know.
And this will likely kind of grow into itself and end up looking more or less like our beautiful purple.
Yes.
At least the shape of it like that.
Put it in full sun, absolutely. And within a month, you're going to start not seeing any space between this. It's going to be so beautiful. And people are going to say, what variety of this is this? It's got so many colors. And you're going to say, it's custom.
I'm going to say, go talk to Shirley.
That's right.